Amen. Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
Amen. I said, praise the Lord once again.
Praise the Lord.
Amen. We're going to call the house to order at this time. Amen. Just so thankful to be in the house one more time. Amen. Glad to see everybody's beautiful faces on today. Amen. We just come to lift up the name of Jesus. We just come to give him praise. We just come to give him glory. We just come to give him honor. We just come to thank him for another day, what he's doing, what he's doing in the service, what he's going to do in our lives. Amen. We come expecting great things from the Lord today.
Yes.
Amen. Whatever you have come in need of, hallelujah, that need can be met today.
Amen.
I thank the Lord today. Hallelujah. Thank you for our bishop and our elect lady. Thank you for all the ministers and the deacons and the missionaries and evangelists and whoever's present, all the saints of God, YouTube, Facebook. We thank you for watching.
Amen.
We just hope that you join with us and worship in our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Come on, let's give the Lord a hand clap of praise today.
Amen.
Come on, he is worthy. He is worthy. Hallelujah. Come on, get those hands clapping. Hallelujah. Come on, lift your voices unto the Lord today. Come on, for he is good. And his mercy endures forever. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Oh, my God. Come on, come on. Who come to desire to worship with me today?
Amen. Come on, come on.
Hallelujah. Come on, the Lord has been too good for us to just sit down on our Father.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Oh, my God.
Yes, Lord.
Come on, just say yes to him right now.
Yes, Lord.
Just say yes to him right now.
Yes, Lord.
Hey, come on, just say yes to him. Just say yes to him right now. Say yes like you mean it. Let it come from your soul. Just say yes. Let it come from your heart and your mind. Hallelujah. Meditate on that word. Meditate on how God has been good to you this week. How he's touched you. How he's delivered you. How he's healed you. How he's brought you through. Hallelujah.
Glorious God. Oh, God, we thank you.
Come on. Let's lift it up to him today. Lift it up to him today.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Oh, God, thank you, Jesus.
Say yes. Say yes. Say yes.
Yes, Lord.
Yes. my God. We gonna go into words of prayer. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
Thank the Lord for me being here today and thank God for waking us all up this morning.
Yes, Lord.
We want to give our praise to the Lord for thanking us for being here to glorify Him in Jesus' name.
Yes, yes.
Lord, help your people, Lord, around the world, Lord Jesus. Go around in north, south, and east, and west, Lord. Touch the souls that are crying out for you, Father. Yes. For they need you right now, Lord Jesus. Lord, we want to thank you, Lord Jesus, for the victory that you have come to do in this world, Lord, because we know you got the head on. And you are in charge.
Yes.
Lord, we want to thank you, Lord, for waking us up this morning, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord, for guiding us, Lord, to get to the church, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for our pastor and our first lady, Lord. Thank you for all the members of the DDCC.
Yes,
Divine Dedication Christian Center, Lord. Yes,
Lord,
we want to give all the praise and glory out to the ones
Lord.
Out there on the line.
Now,
let them hear the word that God is bringing forth in out of Pastor Paul. Let them receive it, Lord Jesus.
Yes,
let them take it into their mind, Lord. Let them walk out, Lord Jesus, that they never walk out before, Lord. Lord, you said you the head and not the tail.
All right.
Lord, you would even not. Lord Jesus, thank you, Lord Jesus.
Thank
you. Lord,
we
just want to give you praise.
Do it, God.
Yes. Lord, just thank you, Lord, that you get up here and say a word, Lord Jesus.
Yes.
Thank you, Lord, that you've been for us, Lord, to glorify you, Father, but no man.
Yes, Lord.
So, Lord, I want to be the woman that you called me to be on this
earth.
Lord, just teach me. Teach me, Lord.
Yeah, God.
Teach me the wrong way.
Lord.
Teach me to talk like you, Lord. Teach everyone in the church, Lord, just stand up and not as you, Lord, not themselves. Lord, we just give you praise and unending glory and victory to your name. Amen.
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 Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Good morning, everyone. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
I will be giving you your scripture reading. It will be coming from the chapter is Psalm 34, verses 1 through 3. One, I will bless the Lord at all times.
Yes.
His praise shall continually be in my mouth.
Yes, God.
Two, my soul shall make her boast in the Lord. The humble shall hear thereof and be glad. Three, oh, magnify the Lord with me and let us exalt his name together. And the word of the Lord is already read and has already been blessed.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. How many of you ready to feel His spirit? How many of you ready to feel His power?
Come on,
somebody. All right, get them holy hands and clap.
Thank
soul. Hallelujah. Admire soul. Hallelujah. Yes. You gotta make it personal with Jesus. Yes. Hallelujah. Admire soul. I don't know about your soul, but my soul. He's moving in my soul. And he's moving your soul. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Just call on him and acknowledge him. Hallelujah. He comes in the room and in your life. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. At this time, we're gonna go ahead and get a dance from our very own evangelist Hunter. Amen. Yeah. May God use you in this hour. Amen. Yeah. Come on, give it. God bless you. And
let us know
that you come to us. Hallelujah.
Glory to God.
Amen.
All right.
Amen.
Yeah.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you,
Jesus. Yeah. Oh, yes,
Lord.
Yes,
Lord.
Up thus far. Amen. Beautiful job by the praise team as always. Amen. We thank God for them. Amen. We thank God for everyone that came out today.
Amen.
Amen.
Truly this is the day that the Lord has made. Amen. I will rejoice and be glad about it.
Yes, Lord.
Amen. We are excited today what God is doing. Not only in this day, I'm excited what God is doing in the ministry.
Amen. Yeah. Amen.
Moving by his own power.
Amen.
And I thank the Lord for that today. Amen. And we give honor and we give space. Amen. We got our very own that's going to break the bread of life.
Amen.
So our very own lady. Amen. I know what's there and I'm just waiting.
Amen.
For it to flow. And I know it's going to flow through the Holy Ghost.
Oh, yes.
All right. Hallelujah.
Through the Holy Ghost. We thank God for a beautiful job, evangelist. Thank you.
Hallelujah.
When you put your all into it, when you can feel, when you can feel it, then your audience can feel it.
Amen.
We thank God for that. So without any further ado, amen, we're going to present something to do for our very own elect lady of the house of DDCC, Prophetess Jonah Anderson.
Amen. Amen. All right.
Let God use you.
Praise the Lord, church.
Praise the Lord
again. The Lord can do better than that. That was for Sister Jonah, but not for my father. Yeah, woke me up this morning. Not for my father. That started to my younger. Not for my father. And then you can help build strength today. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. I was going through, well, the family is going through, transitioning in our family. We're losing our roots. God is taking her back home to him, where she belongs. No more pain, no more heartache, no more discouragement, no more of this world,
amen.
But a new world.
Amen.
And it kind of sometimes we get in the flesh,
amen.
When someone is transitioning on.
Yes.
But God reminded me to be grateful.
That's right.
Of the time that we had with her.
Yes, ma'am.
For me, it's been 47 years.
Mm-hmm.
For some of y'all, it may be 30. Mm-hmm. Grandmother lives to be 91.
Come on.
Amen.
I left her this morning and she was still taking her breaths.
Amen.
Blood pressure dropping.
My God.
But she's at peace.
Yes, God.
And I heard she'll let you must keeping on.
Amen.
You must press on.
Come on.
You must do what God called you to do.
Amen.
It's hard for me to stand before y'all today.
Come on, brother. Come on.
But she has prepared me for this day.
Amen. Come on now.
Amen. And I spoke to God this morning when I woke up. I said, God, you haven't given me the words to give to your people this week. But he's an on time God.
Yes, he is.
Always on time.
And then he gave me completing your assignment from God.
I am grateful for the things that you
book of Jonah.
That's right.
And I'm going to give you just what God gave me.
Come on, right?
Not going to add anything to it. And I'm not going to take anything away.
That's it.
But he reminded me to be grateful of the good times, to be grateful in the bad times.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
To be grateful when I'm going up.
All right.
And to be grateful.
Hallelujah.
When I'm going down.
Yes. That's it. That's it.
It's not what I look like.
Come on now.
Many people look at me and they want to read the story. But you don't know the book. And for those of you that think you got the book down pat, you got to read the chapters. And then once you get into the chapters, you gotta take one verse at a time.
All right.
So God told me this morning, while I'm preparing the meal to take to the family, he said, your book is not closed.
My God.
Your chapters have not all been written. He said, you must go forth.
Hallelujah.
Because I got greater work for you to do.
Greater.
He said, don't worry about what man said. Because man didn't make you. Don't worry about what woman said. Because woman didn't create you.
All right.
Don't worry about what you look like. Because you're not what it looked like. You're not what you're going through.
Right.
Because I am who I said I am.
All right.
And some of y'all worry about what you've been going through and how it looks like and how it feels. And God said it's not in the feeling.
Come on now. Come on now. So true.
You're not even going through for yourself.
All right.
You're going through to help bring somebody else. Every time I turn around, some dogs are hitting my back, pushing me, going to the left, going to the right.
Man.
Every time my good deeds try to get weighted down, somebody was there to try to pull me down, take my joy, take my strength, take my happiness. But God said, it is not so.
All right.
Come on. So. Not so.
You have not completed your assignment yet.
Right there.
You have not completed your assignment yet.
Amen.
Prophet Jonah. Prophet Jonah had an assignment.
Yep, he did.
And it's something about when God give you an assignment,
right.
It seems so tough.
Yeah.
It seems unbearable. Mm. It seems like I just don't want to do it, God.
All right.
I know. Because that's me.
My God.
I know.
Speak, Lord.
Because I've been there. And done that.
Well,
and some days I still do that. Run from the assignment.
All right. Come on. Come on. Call it. Come on. Call it.
Where you go?
Come on. Right.
And the more I run, the more God pulls me down. The more I run, the more God hooks me.
My God.
The more I run, the things in my life begin to turn around.
All right.
True.
So true. Hallelujah.
That's it.
Yeah.
Hello.
You in the house.
Brother Jonah had an assignment.
That's great.
Chapter 1, verse 1 through 5. I ask that you stand for the reading of the word. Now, the word of the Lord came unto Jonah, the son of Amittai, saying, Arise, go to Nineveh, the great city, and cry against it, for their wickedness has come up before me. But Jonah rose up to flee unto Tarshish from the presence of the Lord, and went down to Joppa. And he found a ship going to Tarshish.
Yeah.
So he paid the fare thereof and went down into it to go with them unto Tarshish from the presence of the Lord. Mm-hmm. But the Lord sent out a great wind into the sea, and there was a mighty tempest in the sea, so that the ship was like to be broken. Then the mariners were afraid and cried every man unto his God and cast forth the wares that were in the ship into the sea to lighten it of them. But Jonah was gone down into the sides of the ship, and he lay and was fast asleep.
Amen.
And will you give me verse 7?
Amen.
And they said every one to his fellow, Come, and let us cast lots, that we may know for whose cause this evil is upon us. Mm-hmm. So they cast lots, and the lot fell upon Jonah.
All right. Prophet Jonah, y'all may be seated.
Amen.
First, you know,
Amen.
To the bishop of this home, thank him for opening the floor to the women today.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord, for my sister showing up.
Amen.
It's Women Day, y'all.
Yes.
And God has something in store for you.
All right.
Give me a little bit of my music. Just a little. Thank you. It's something about music when I'm going through. It calms me.
Amen.
It soothes me.
Amen.
It helps me.
Lord.
Some of us need to put a scripture in our mind daily.
Mm-hmm.
And some of us need a song.
Amen.
That's true.
But we finna move on with completing your assignment.
Wow.
That's it.
From God.
Come on now.
Amen.
That's good.
Come on,
people. Brother Jonah. Had an assignment.
All right.
Yes, he did.
My God.
God gave him instructions. Mm-hmm. He told Brother Jonah to go and do a task. He didn't tell him to go to Egypt.
No.
He didn't tell him to go to Moroville.
Okay, all right.
He didn't tell him to go to Mobile.
All right.
Come on now.
He told him to go to a city.
All right then.
Amen.
And he wanted him to give these people instructions.
All right.
Amen.
Instructions.
That's it.
The instructions was to repent from their sins.
Amen.
Because they have got so wicked in their ways.
My God.
But God still loved.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
God still had his hand on them.
All right, come on.
God still wanted to give them another chance.
All right, come on.
Just like you and I today.
Yes.
He's still calling us for another chance. We're not so clean.
No.
Come on.
We're not so holy.
No.
We're not so perfect.
No.
But we do belong to God.
Hallelujah.
And what belong to God, he chases.
Come on.
What belong to him, he's calling your name. What belong to him, he give you another chance.
Yes,
another opportunity.
Get it right.
But Brother Jonah, being the prophet, didn't want to follow the assignment. Didn't want to go and warn God's people. Didn't want to go tell them that God said your wicked ways.
Right.
Turn from your wicked ways. Yeah. It's time out for them wicked ways. Stop doing the things that you know is ungodly. Stop doing the things that you know God do not like.
That's right.
Stop hurting your brothers and your sisters.
All right.
Stop going being backbiters. Stop being liars. Stop being cheaters.
Come on now.
Whatever your sin is.
Come on now.
Come on, right.
Stop it. Enough is enough.
Amen.
That's it.
That's it.
Come on.
My God.
And I'm quite sure Brother Jonah prophet was like, but God, I don't want to go and warn the people. Matter of fact, he didn't go and warn them that first time.
Mm-mm.
Instead, he went, well,
on the ship.
On the ship.
Yeah.
He didn't go to the right. He went to the left.
That's right.
He disobeyed God.
That's right. Disobeyed.
Won't disobedience get us in trouble?
Oh, yeah.
Won't disobedience cause us some hurt and some pain?
Right. Oh, yeah.
Won't disobedience cause some things to turn around in your life?
Oh, yeah. Yes,
won't disobedience stop your blessing?
My God.
Won't disobedience shake you up and pat you where it hurts? Brother Jonah thought he escaped the assignment. He thought he could run, and he thought he could hide. But I'm here to tell you, church, today, you can't hide or run from God.
That's right.
You can hide what you do behind doors from man, but you cannot hide or run from God.
All right. True anyway.
Not from God.
Thank you.
Brother Jonah got on a boat. He went to sleep. He felt that comfortable.
Come on now.
And God commanded the wind to blow.
All right.
Start raging. And once it started blowing on the water, guess what happened? A storm started brewing.
All right.
That boat began to rock. That boat began to shift.
All right.
The people on the boat began to get afraid.
Yeah. Come on.
I remember my first cruise trip with Pastor. I told Pastor we stayed in the room. I looked over the board and I said, this must be what Noah and the ark were. I seen no land.
Man.
I seen just water. And every now and then a little bird. So I told Pastor, the safest place for us would be in the middle. When that boat begins to rock. So the storm caused that ship to rock. And the people on the boat began to get afraid.
All right. Come on now.
They began to wonder what in the world caused this storm.
Mm.
Before it was calm, cool, and collected.
Wow.
Yes.
True.
Yes, it was.
But when Brother Jonah hit the boat, things begin to rock.
All right.
Things begin to shake it up. God begin to do some stuff on
that
boat.
All right. Come on.
You can't run and you can't hide.
No.
Complete the assignment.
That's it.
So the captain and the shipmates, they want to know what happened. Where this storm come from? Why all of this destruction began to rock the boat? But you in the world, you know, they had a song called Rock the Boat.
Rock the Boat.
And for you that's Christians, Mary and Mary say, in the middle of. So I want to stay in the middle of the boat.
All right.
Then I heard and I read that the people say, hold up now. Let's cast some lots. Who brought this trouble to us?
All right.
Ain't that just like man today?
Wow.
When things not going right in your life, we want to find out who brought this storm to
us. All right, who brought the curse?
Where did this storm come from?
Come on.
Where did this wind start blowing my way? What do I need to do a little different in order to get back on track?
Amen.
Come on.
Yes, Lord.
And when they tossed the lot, The lot landed on Jonah. Mm. Remember, I told you, brother, Jonah was asleep.
All right.
He wasn't worried about nothing.
Yeah. Nope.
Brother Jonah didn't even feel the boat rock.
No, didn't.
He was calm and cool.
Oh, he did.
But he knew where the storm came from.
All right. All right.
He knew that he caused the storm.
Yeah.
Because God gave him an assignment that he was running from.
All right.
So Brother Jonah, still running from his assignment, had the boat rocking.
Look out now.
And he told the men, I'm the reason why your boat is rocking.
Yeah, man. Yeah. That's right. That's right.
He told the men, I'm the reason why your ship is not going smooth.
All right.
But
okay,
it's rocking.
That's true.
Rocking.
He said, but if you cast me aside of your boat, things will change.
All right.
Amen.
How many of you know? That's a hard task.
Yes, ma'am.
Some of us today, we're like, nah. And I know it's me, but I ain't going to confess it.
Amen.
But Brother Jonah knew it was him.
All right.
They caused the ship to start rocking.
Yep.
They caused the wind to start blowing because God commanded the wind.
That's right.
God still has our power to speak over his creation.
Yes, he did.
God caused the wind to blow,
the
sea to move, the rock to shake, your world to turn around, and you become uneasy, and you become under
Oh, Jesus. He caused
it. That's right.
Shake it up.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
The Peter began to pray today, God. But Jonah prayed to the mighty God.
All right.
And this is what caught my attention, y'all. As I was reading this morning, God was speaking to me. He said, when I give you an assignment to do, I don't care how it looks. I don't care who make it hurt. I don't care what people say. I don't care what you gotta go through in order to get to. I say do the assignment.
Amen.
And until you do your assignment, your boat shall be rocking. Your boat shall be rocking. Your blessings will be on hold.
Okay, then.
Every door you walk through shall become closed.
Amen.
Because you have not completed the assignment.
That's it.
Come on now.
Wow, this work. Wow. How God speaks.
Yes.
How he opens your eyes up.
Yes.
So they cast Brother Noah overboard. And I read that a great mammal. Some said, well, swallowed him up. It amazed me that even in the time of my destruction, God still have a ram in the bush.
All right, girl.
To keep me. God still making a way out of no way. God still providing miracles today. Just like he provided that well for Brother Jonah.
All right.
He provided a well for you too.
All right. Amen, amen.
Some of our wells, bills are getting paid.
Yes.
And we didn't know it was going to get paid.
That's right.
Some of our wells, a sister come and just give you a hug when you just need it because you're feeling down and out.
All right.
And she just say, Lord, sister, that I love you. And something within your belly begins to change because you felt like nobody loved you. You felt like that you were ugly. You felt like you didn't have a friend. But who knows what God gonna send you in the time of your destiny and your need.
All right.
The well.
Yes,
y'all.
Yes, no.
He always has a ram in the bush.
All right. Amen. Yes, he does. Always. He always does.
So while John was in the well, belly, and just think about the acid. He's supposed to have been dissolved.
Mm-hmm.
But but he was not dissolved.
All right.
He did not die in the belly well.
That's right.
Well, belly.
No, he did.
Instead, he began to remember the man that made the man, the creator that made this God of all things. And he began to cry out to God.
Yeah, he did.
He began to say, God, forgive me.
Yeah,
he began to repent from his sins. All
right.
He remembered that God has all power.
All power.
Yes, sir.
And for 3 days in the belly, Jonah talked to God.
All right.
Yes,
some of y'all don't want to take 30 seconds just to talk to God.
Yeah.
He didn't say it had to be a long spiel. He said, just come as you are, hurt, broken, destroyed, and talk to me.
Come on, that's it. Let's go.
You and I conversation would stay just between you and I. But I can go tell Susie, and Susie tell Mary, and Mary tell John, and John tell Eric, and Eric tell David, and David tell.
Ooh.
But if I take it to God, one-on-one, God will answer my prayer.
Amen.
Take it to God. God will answer my need. Take it to God. All my things in my life will be broken that need to be broken.
Yes.
Thank you,
Father.
It's gratefulness.
All right.
Amen.
Then I hear that after Jonah repented to God and God saw his heart, and Jonah decided that, yes, Lord, I will do what you call me to do.
Yeah.
I'm not going to fight anymore. Mm. I'm tired of getting beat down, broken down, shaken down to the ground.
All right. Break it down.
I'll rise up. I shall walk the walk.
Yes, Lord.
I shall talk the talk. I shall go and warn your people of destruction that coming in 40 days. If they don't change.
My God.
All right.
That if is a conjunction, y'all.
Yes, it is.
That means with a conjunction, you in, that's English scholars.
Yep.
If I do this, something in my life gonna change.
That's right.
But if I decide to stay the same way, then destruction will happen.
That's right.
Because God has already warned me.
Blood
would have
been on
his
hands. So Jonah went and completed his assignment.
Amen.
He went to the city and he told the people what God's words were.
Amen.
He didn't add to it. He didn't take anything away.
That's it.
You must change from your evil, wicked way. If not, in 40 days, God is going to destroy this city. When the king got word and ear of it, and I love this king for this action, not only did he hear it, he listened to it, he put action behind it.
Amen.
He told his people, not just tell them, he commanded his people.
Come on now.
Everyone shall go on a fast.
All right.
Yeah.
No drinking, no eating. We shall pray to the God.
Come on,
Almighty.
Amen.
And I told my husband on the way here.
Even the animals.
I said, baby, not only did he tell the people, but he also told the animals.
My God.
No eating. No drinking. Everything in his surrounding.
All right.
Everything in his city must be on one accord.
I don't know. Come on now.
Great things happen when everybody gets on one accord. Great things happen when everybody shifts to one assignment. Great things happen when we all come together in unity. God begins to work. God begins to mend. God begins to heal. God begins to shift. God begins to open up doors. I don't know about that, but I got excited. I said, God, if the animals can fast, why can't Hallelujah. If the animal can cry out to you, Lord, why can't we? Lord, just take me as I am. Dirty, filthy, not as 100, even 99 will work, Lord. But he said he wants all of us.
All right, all of us. Come on. Come on.
Not half. All of you.
All
not 99.
Come on,
and a half. It just won't do.
Come on. Won't do.
But when everybody get on one accord, great things happen. God spared the city.
My God, yes, he did.
He spared the people.
Hallelujah.
He spared the animals.
Jesus. All right.
Great things begin to happen. And how many of you know, and I'm about to close, that when great things begin to happen in your life, people get upset with you.
Oh, yeah.
They start hating on you.
Yeah.
Come on now. What you think
right.
She is?
All right.
They begin to get jealous.
Come on now.
Oh, she thinks she's all there because of her hair. Oh, look at her walk. Oh, look at her house. Oh, look at her car. Oh, she cook good. Oh, she's always got a smile on her face. Child. What's she smiling at?
Come on now.
But when God have a plan in your life,
that's it. That's it.
No man can stop it. No man, they can try, but it won't stop it. Because what God has for you, it is for you. What God has for me, it is for me. What God has for you, it is for you. What God has for you, it is for you. What God has for you, it is for you. I hear great things is coming to the divine direction.
Yeah.
It's on the way.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes,
Lord. Yes, Lord.
Yes,
Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes,
Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Thank you.
Yes, Lord. Lord, I thank you.
Lord, I thank you. Lord, I thank you. Lord, I praise you. Lord, I lift you up. Lord, I glorify you, Lord. I give you the honor. I give you the praises. Oh, I bless your name, Lord, today. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you for your healing.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you for your deliverance.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you, 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 Lord.
Because if it had not, Been for the Lord.
Who's on my side?
Who's on my side?
Ah, yeah. Where would I be?
Where would we be?
My side.
Where would we be, people? If it had not been for him. Who's on our side?